This is part 2 of our Spring project. In this video, we will continue with the CRUD operations that we have done in the previous video. We will insert few more hotel instances into the database, learn to retrieve hotel by ID, update hotel and delete hotel. Together with that, we will also use derived queries to retrieve the hotels based on city and location, use @ query annotation to work with menus and deliveries. Now let us go into the application. This is the main class that we were working with. Now let us try to add few more hotel instances to the database table. The first thing that we need to do is go to application.properties, change create to none. It means that we are disabling the data definition language handling by Hibernate. We don't want to create or alter the existing table. We just want to update the tables with values. Next, let us go to the main class. Let us create a new hotel instance and save it to the database. Hotel has one-to-one relationship with address. So let us create a new address instance. I will change the values. In case of menu, one hotel has many menus. The menu names can be same or it can be different. So I am just leaving the first one, changing the second one. In case of delivery, one hotel can have many delivery partners. One delivery partner can have many hotels. So instead of me creating a new delivery instance, I am going to work with the existing delivery instance. That is, for this hotel also, I need Swiggy only. So how to get that? We need to create a service layer for this delivery also. Let me just create that. Similar to hotel service, in the service layer, we need an interface for delivery service. In delivery service, we can add few methods. Now, just like hotel service, I will add few methods. Get delivery by ID. And also, we need one more method. Get delivery by partner name. So, it is string partner name. Let me also create an implementation class. Delivery service IMPL. We need to autowire delivery repository. The methods update, delete and get delivery by ID doesn't need any implementation because we are going to call the implementation of JPA repository. But for get delivery by partner, we need to use derived queries. Let us start writing the logic. Delivery repository dot save delivery, and then for delete, delete by ID, pass the delivery ID. For get delivery by ID, just like for hotel, it is delivery repository dot find by ID dot get method. Coming to get delivery by partner, we cannot use any existing implementation of JPA repository. We need to go in for derived queries. So now let us add the derived queries in delivery repository. The derived queries can be in the form of find by property name, get by property name, or read by property name. In our case, we want to get the delivery details based on the partner name. So let us start with find by the property that is in delivery class. Let me go to the delivery class. The property name that I have is partner name. So I'll just copy it. In delivery repository, find by partner name. P should be capital. And it takes string partner name as parameter. The return type is one delivery instance. So I hope it is clear. Find by the property name. Partner name is the property that is in delivery. So we are appending it to find by and passing the partner name. So this is called as a derived query. Now coming to delivery service IMPL, I can call the method from here. Delivery repository dot find by partner name and passing the partner name. This is good. Now I'll come to the main class. There is some error here also. One semicolon is missing. Now, coming to the main class, we need to autowire delivery service. Using the delivery service, we will get one instance of delivery based on the partner name. So let me call the method delivery service dot get delivery by partner, and I'm passing the partner name. So for this hotel, I want to have the partner as Swiggy only. I want only one partner. So I'm removing the second DEL2. Fine. And let us give the hotel name also. I will give the hotel name as the Indies. Address, menu list and delivery list. All good to go. I'll save the application completely. I'll relaunch the application. It's giving me an error saying hotel app.service.delivery service is not available. So what I have missed? I have not added @service annotation. So let me add that. Okay. Now again we will relaunch the application. It's giving me a very big exception. Let us just read that. Detached entity pass to persist. So there are two things we need to do. The first step is in the service layer, we are sending an entity from the service layer to the front end to the main class. So we need to use @transaction. It means we want to carry the transaction across methods. So let me add @transactional. This annotation should be from Spring Framework. Again, I will just copy it above the method, meaning to say that the transaction should continue across methods for this and for this. Okay. Again, we will try running this application. Okay. I'll maximize it. Still, I'm getting the same error, detached entity passed to persist. I'll tell you the reason. Let me go to the hotel class. Here we have used cascade type dot persist. It means when you are saving the hotel instance, the delivery instance also should be saved. But the delivery instance is detached because we are not using a new keyword. We are trying to retrieve an existing delivery from the database table. So that is why we are getting this error. So these are the two main reasons. One thing is you have missed transactional. The other thing is this should not be persist. Instead, this should be merge. If you are using new keyword, you need persist. If you are trying to retrieve an existing entity, in that scenario, use merge. Now I will save this. Rerun the application. This is just a use case scenario. The values are inserted into the database table properly. Let us check this out. I'll open MySQL command line. Let me just give select star from hotel. So here I have got this, the second hotel. In between we had more additions and deletions, that is why the ID is incremented to 152. Now let us try adding two more hotels. I'll come to the main class. For the third entry also, I am having the delivery as Swiggy only. Let me relaunch the application. Okay. Now here again we will check it out. Now you can see how the ID is getting incremented. It is adding +50 for every ID. If you want to change, of course, you can go to the database and change it from there. I will add one more hotel also, this time with Uber. I'll save it. I'll relaunch the application. Okay, it is inserted. Now let us see this. So we have got four hotels added. Let us check the hotels having the appropriate deliveries. So let me use a join, select h.hotel_name, d.partner_name from hotel h, left join hotel_delivery hd on h.hotel_id = h.hotel_id, then left join delivery d on d dot delivery underscore id equal to ht dot delivery underscore id. Enter. So now you can see A to B has Uber, Cakewold has Uber, A to B also has Swiggy, Indies and Truffles have only Swiggy. So I hope this part is clear. We have learned how to insert the values into the database table from a Spring Boot application. Next, let us move on to the update, delete and get hotel by ID part. So let me call hotel service dot get hotel by ID. I need to pass the ID. I think we are having 202. It returns a hotel instance. Hotel equal to hotel service dot get hotel by ID. Already we have given the implementation properly over here. We have used find by ID. This is the JPA implementation, so we don't have to bother about that. And I will comment these things. Let me print the hotel instance. When you try to print the hotel instance, it will print the hotel name, address details, street name, city, state, zip code, menu list, menu name, price, delivery details, partner name and charges. Let us also try to call update hotel method. Hotel service dot update hotel. We need to change some property of the hotel, then only we can update it. So for that, I'll go here and I will call hotel dot get address dot set city. So we are trying to get for 202. That is the last one, I hope so. Yeah. So here we have given it as Bangalore. I'll change it to some other city, Carver. Okay, I am updating the hotel. We will again check this out by printing the hotel instance. I'll relaunch the application now. You can always check the SQL statements if you are having any confusion. So here we are calling get hotel by ID. Internally it is calling find by ID method. So it is select star from hotel all blah blah stuffs where hotel ID equal to question mark. It is printing the hotel details, the truffles. Bangalore, Karnataka. Menu list, pancake and burger and so on and on. Next is we are trying to update the city for this particular hotel. Now you can see in the last line the city is changed to Carver. Okay, fine. Similar to this, you can also try deleting a hotel based on the ID. Now I will move on to the next part, that is derived queries. Let me go into the hotel service IMPL. Here I have few methods which require derived queries and at the rate query annotation. To start with, we will try implementing get hotels by city. Let me go into the hotel repository. Here we need to add the derived queries part. Already I told you the derived query should start with either find by property name, get by property name or read by property name. So in this case, we are trying to get the hotels by city. City is not a property of hotel, but address is a property of hotel. So I have to pass find by address. Address is not a primitive type, but it is a class by itself. In address class, we have city. So I need to append city to address. It should be in uppercase. So the derived query goes like this. It is find by the property name. If the property name is a primitive type, append the property name next to by with the first letter capital, just like what we have done in delivery repository, find by partner name, wherein partner name is of type string. In case if your property name is a class by itself, attach the class name, then identify the appropriate property in that class and attach it to the end of the class name. So in our case, address is a class, so we have attached address next to by and appended city after address and pass string city. It returns a list of hotels. It is list hotel find by address city. Now in the IMPL class, I can call the method hotel repository dot find by address city. Same way we can write the derived query for get hotels by location. By location we mean the street name. So let me go to the hotel repository. Again it is find by address address has street name. Let me add street name. S should be capital and pass string location as parameter. Here also the return type is a list of hotels. Okay, I will import it. And in hotel service, it is hotel repository dot find by address street name and pass the location. Okay, we have to save hotel repository, then the error will be gone. Fine. Now I will come to the main class. I will comment this part also. We will try calling both the methods. So it is hotel service dot get hotels by city by passing Bangalore. I am using Java 8 streams API. So it is dot stream dot for each use method references system dot out double colon println, and I will also add for get hotels by location. In this case, you have to give the exact location. It will fetch the list of hotels in that particular location. What if I want to have a matching wildcard? Like find the list of hotels in a particular location ending with Nagar or having Nagar. In that scenario, we need to use @ query annotation. Now here, I will just use JP Nagar. Fine. Now I will save this. We will relaunch the application. Fine, it is giving me the hotel list in Bangalore. So I have only one hotel in Bangalore. Yeah, you can see that. And then giving the hotel based on location, which I have as JP Nagar City, Bangalore. Now, if I want to print only the hotel name and city, I can just do that. I'll do the implementation directly. H dot get hotel name. Plus h dot get address dot get city, and for this also I will just modify it, and instead of city let me just print the menu details, menu list. Okay, fine. Now let me add one more hotel also with same JP Nagar and Bangalore. Fine. Now I will run it again. Here we have got the output. In the first case, it has to print the hotel name and city. So here I have got A to B Bangalore, New Arias Bangalore. Okay, fine. In the next case, we are trying to get the hotel name and menu list, and for the list of hotels in JP Nagar, Cake World and New Arias from JP Nagar, and it is also giving the list of menus. Okay, this is good to go. So we have learned how to use derived queries. Next, let us move on to @ query annotation. For that, again, I'll go to hotel service IMPL. We are having three more methods that has to be implemented using @ query annotation. Let me go to the hotel repository. For working with @ query annotation, we can give any method name. The first method that I want to implement is get hotels by menu. So I'll come over here. Let me just create the method get hotels by menu. It takes string menu name as argument. The return type is going to be a list of hotels. Okay, fine. This method should be annotated with @ query, within which we are going to write JPQL, Java Persistence Query Language. Now within double quotes, let me start the query from hotel. Here, hotel represents the entity name, not the table name. So hotel H, inner join H dot, select the property in hotel that represents this menu. So in hotel, we have a property menu list that represents menu. So it is H dot menu list MN, where MN dot select the property in menu which represents or which is equivalent to this menu name. In case of menu, let me go to the menu class. We have menu name. It is the exact same name. So I'll copy it. mn dot menu name equal to question mark 1. I will explain it again. From hotel h, here hotel represents the entity name h, inner join h dot, select the property in hotel which represents menu. In our case, in hotel we have menu list which represents menu, where mn dot select the property in menu which represents the property menu name. So menu name is the same name that we have given. So this is the property which we want to check in, equal to question mark 1. For this one, the value will be taken from the parameter directly. Let me import query. Okay, fine. Now let us call this method from hotel service IMPL. Here it is hotel repository dot get hotels by menu by passing the menu name. Similar to this, let us also implement get hotels by delivery. I'll come to the hotel repository. We want the hotels by delivery. It takes the partner name as parameter and it has to return a list of hotels. Let us add the query annotation again. @ query from hotel h inner join h dot, select the property in hotel which represents delivery. Let me go to hotel. Here it is the same name delivery. I'll copy it. H dot delivery d, where d dot select the property in delivery which represents the partner name. So this is my delivery class. Here it is the same name, partner name only. I'll copy it. Partner name equal to question mark 1. So this is also good to go. Here if you see, in JPQL we can give the keywords in capital letter. Of course we can use lowercase also, but the best practice is to use capitals. So let me just change inner join also in capitals. Even if you are giving in lowercase, it will work fine. Let us call this method from hotel service IMPL. So in get hotels by delivery, it is hotel repository dot get hotels by delivery by passing the partner name. We have one more method to be implemented, get hotels by location and menu. We will do that later. First we will try calling these two methods, get hotels by menu and get hotels by delivery. I'll go to the main class. Again let me comment this part. We will also add for JP Nagar and Bangalore one more hotel. While running this application, this hotel also will be added automatically. Now let me call hotel service dot get hotel by menu by passing the menu name, maybe as Italy, dot stream dot for each. So here no method reference. I'll try to print the hotel name and the location. H dot get address dot get street name. Fine. Same way we'll do it for delivery also. I'll have one extra println statement and it is get hotels by delivery, and the partner name of course we have for Swiggy more. So let me just pass Swiggy. Okay, fine. Before running this application, let me open application.properties and I will come and show SQL. I just want to see the output, that's it. Now we will run the application. So here we are getting the output, the Indies, New Arias and Shantos for Idli, and for Swiggy A to B Indies and Truffles. So how to check it out? We can check it out from MySQL command line. I'll just open it. Let me do a inner join with menus. Select h dot hotel underscore name comma m dot menu underscore name from hotel h inner join menu m, where m dot hotel underscore id equal to h dot hotel underscore ID where m dot menu underscore name equal to idli. So here you can see the output. I have done an inner join to get the hotel name and the menu name. It is the Indies, New Arias and the Shantus. So that's what we have got over here. Indies, New Arias and Shantus. Similar to that, you can try for delivery also. In case of delivery, the relationship is many to many. So you need to use hotel underscore delivery also while joining. Let us check that. Already we have done it in the first time. I will just select that particular query. So this was the query which we used earlier. Hotel name, partner name from hotel, inner join, hotel underscore delivery. The same query I have used, but I am using inner join where d dot partner underscore name equal to Swiggy. Enter. So we have got the same output, A to B, Indies and Truffles. So here the output is the same. Let us now move on to the next method, get hotels by location menu. The method is here in hotel service IMPL. Get hotels by location and menu. By location, we mean the street name in address, and by menu, we mean the menu name that is in menu class. Here, we are trying to do an inner join of hotel with address and menu. Now, let us try to write the method in the hotel repository. I'll copy the same method name. Get hotels by location and menu. It takes location and menu name as arguments. And it is going to return me a list of hotels. Right. Now let us write the query annotation. @query and we will add the JPQL. Here we are going to do an inner join of hotel with address and menu. It is from hotel H inner join H dot. Find the property in hotel that refers to location. We don't have location or street name directly in hotel, but we have address. So I need to take this address property. H.address A. Then again I need to do another inner join. Inner join H. Find the property in hotel that refers to menu name. We don't have menu name directly in hotel, but we have a menu list. So I'll copy this property also and pass h.menuList mn where a.location is referred by the property street name. So it is a.streetName equal to ?1 and mn. The property menu name is the same in menu class. So we don't have to change the name. We can just pass it as such equal to ?2. Now let me explain this JPQL query. Here we are doing an inner join of hotel with address and menu class. Address and menu are entities, they are not tables. By location, we try to mean the street name in address class, and by menu name, we refer to the menu name in menu class. Let me call this method from hotel service IMPL. It is hotel repository dot get hotels by location and menu. By passing the location and menu name. Good. Now we'll go to the main class. In the main class, we'll try to call the method. So it is hotel service dot get hotels by location and menu. And I'll pass the location as JP Nagar and menu name, I'll pass it as idli dot for each. And here also we'll try to print the hotel name and the city. Let me comment the previous method calls. We will relaunch the application. The application has started and it is giving me the output New Arias and the Shantos with the city name. Let us check this out from MySQL command line. We are doing an inner join of two tables. So it is select h dot hotel underscore name comma a dot city from hotel h inner join menu m on m dot hotel underscore id equal to h dot hotel underscore id. Here hotel id in menu table is a foreign key. It refers to the hotel id in hotel table. Again we need to do an inner join on address also inner join address A on A dot address underscore id equal to h dot address underscore id. In this case, the address id in the hotel table is a foreign key and it refers to the address id in address table. So this is basic SQL which you know already. Next we will use the where class, where a dot street underscore name equal to JP Nagar and m dot menu underscore name equal to idli. Let me press enter. I missed a semicolon. Let me rewrite the query again. Now I'll press enter. Now we have got the same output, new Aryas and the Shantos. Okay, fine. This is about at the rate query annotation. So we have learned how to use derived queries and also at the rate query annotation. Together with this, let us also learn to use native query. When I say native query, it is nothing but the normal SQL query statements. To understand native queries, instead of working with hotel, let us try working with menus. If you see in hotel service, we are trying to get the list of hotels based out of a particular city or for a particular menu or for a particular delivery or location. That is, if I pass the city or menu, it has to give me a list of hotels. Now what I want is, I want to get the list of menus for a particular hotel. So for this, we need to create the service layer for menu. So let me create the service layer, select the package, right click new interface. This interface is menu service. Here, let me add the method. I want to get the list of menus for a particular hotel. So the method is get menus by hotel. The argument is hotel name. This is going to return me a list of menus. Now let me import this. Fine. We will also create the implementation class for this. It is menu service IMPL. Add menu service. Fine. And this class should be annotated with @service. And we need to auto-wire menu repository. Till now, we have not added any method in menu repository. Now let us go and add the logic for get menus by hotel. Okay. Here, we will try all the methodologies. First one is derived queries. Then, using @ query annotation with JPQL. Then, @ query with SQL. That is native query. Let us first start with derived queries. The method that has to be implemented is get menus by hotel. Get the list of menus by the hotel name. So, for that, we will start with find by. Identify the property in menu that refers to hotel. So it is hotel itself. But hotel by itself is a class. We cannot use it directly. So what we need to identify the property in hotel that refers to the hotel name. So here it is hotel name itself. So I'll copy it and I will append it to the end of hotel. And this has to be in capital. So I don't need this. And it takes string hotel name as argument. This method will return me a list of menus. Let me explain it. I want to get the list of menus for a particular hotel. So for that, we are identifying the property in menu which refers to hotel. So by itself, it is hotel only. Hotel is a class, so you need to identify the appropriate property that refers to hotel name. The name itself is hotel name. We have appended it directly. Let me import list. Okay, done. Now, we will try to call this method from menu service IMPL. It is menu repository dot find by hotel name and passing the hotel name. So, we are trying to get the list of menus for a particular hotel. We will go to the main class. In the main class, the first thing is we need to auto-wire menu service. So it is menu service. Here it is menu service. I'll import it. We'll try calling the method. Again, I will comment these two lines. It is menu service dot get menus by hotel. we need to pass the hotel name. Let me pass the hotel name as A to B dot for each. Here we are getting the list of menus. Take one menu and print the menu name and the price. We will run this application again. You can now see the output. I am getting pizza and paratha. Let us check this from MySQL command line. Select m dot menu underscore name comma m dot price from menu m inner join hotel h on h dot hotel underscore id equal to m dot hotel underscore id where h dot hotel underscore name equal to a to b. Now we have got the same output, pizza and paratha. So I hope this part is clear. Okay, what we have done is we have used derived queries. Now we will modify this to @ query annotation with JPQL. Let us write the method. I'll change the method as find by hotel. The method name can be anything, right? Let us now add @ query annotation within which we will pass JPQL. So within double quotes, from menu m inner join m dot identify the property in m which refers to hotel. So here we have got hotel itself directly. I'll copy it. M dot hotel h where h dot identify the property in hotel that refers to hotel name. You all know that in hotel the name is hotel name only. So I'll copy it. Hotel name equal to ?1. We'll try to call this method from menu service IMPL. This I will comment it. And then it is here we are calling find by hotel method. Now let me go to the main class. There is no change in get menus by hotel. We have just modified only the menu repository part. I'll run the application now. We should get the same output, pizza and paratha. Right, we are getting the same output. Fine. Now let us move on to the third methodology using native queries. So let me copy the same method and I will comment these two lines. In case of native query, you are going to use same @ query annotation with two attributes. The first attribute is value, where you will pass the proper SQL statement, comma, the second attribute is native query, wherein you specify that it is true. So now here, let us write the SQL query. Select star from menu. Here, menu refers to the table name. Menu M inner join hotel H on M dot hotel underscore ID equal to H dot hotel underscore ID where the query is bit bigger h dot hotel underscore name equal to ?1. This is a proper SQL statement. Here menu and hotel are table names and hotel underscore ID, hotel underscore name are the column names in the appropriate tables. In the previous case in JPQL, if you see, menu refers to the entity name and hotel and hotel name refers to the property in the appropriate entities. So that is the difference. In case of JPQL, you will talk in terms of Java. In case of native query, you are talking in terms of SQL. So this is the query. Now I will save it. No change in menu service IMPL because we are using the same method name and no change in the main class as well. Now let me run this application. I should get the same output. Yeah, I have got the same output, pizza and paratha. So this is about native queries. I hope it is clear. In this particular video, we have learned how to work with different repositories, call the methods in the repositories, use derived queries, @ query annotation with JPQL and native queries. In part 3, we will convert this application into a REST API, add exception handling and few more stuffs. That's it. Thank you.